Distinguished guests, brothers and sisters, Kerala government made a promise to the people of Kerala when it came to power a second time 6 months ago in May 2021 that we shall continue our endeavors with determination to make Kerala the best state for industrial development, that we shall make Kerala a destination for responsible investments and responsible industries. In line with this promise, the state government has been very proactive in taking up many initiatives to energize and stimulate the industrial and business environment in the state. It has rolled out many policy reforms to facilitate responsible investment and accelerate industrial growth. The government has carved out a new approach for resilient and sustainable industrial development. This is based on the principles of 5 R's framework for sustainability, zero waste, focusing on responsible industries and investments, reducing regulatory compliance burden, robust industrial infrastructure, renewed logistics ecosystem, and resilient trust sector. Kerala has been the first state in the country to enact a one-stop omnibus legislation. This has radically helped to facilitate a smooth setup experience for investors, both prospective and existing. This required a bold legislative enactment, namely the Kerala Investment Promotion and Facilitation Act 2018. As part of government's forward-looking policies, 2 path-breaking IT-enabled initiatives, the Kerala Single Window Interface for Fast and Transparent Clearance, KSIFT, and the Invest Kerala web portal have been introduced. Another noteworthy initiative to make regulatory compliance smooth and frictionless has been the creation of the online Kerala Central Inspection System, KSIS. The measures that government has adopted in the recent years have given us rich results. The state was badly affected by natural calamities, 1 cyclone and 2 successive floods during the period 2017 to 2019. Despite that, the gross state value added, GSVA, grew at relatively faster rates during the period from 2016 to 2019. Kerala is now a leader for medium, small and micro enterprises, MSMEs, with 23 lakh estimated number of enterprises as per records of the Government of India. What is remarkable is that out of this, 47% of units were formed in last 5 years. The state holds over 130 sector-focused industrial parks and facilities. Kerala's Industrial Infrastructure Development Corporation, KINFRA, has more than 30 sector-focused industrial parks in food processing, IT, spices, textile, seafood, rubber, electronics. Kerala State Industrial Development Corporation, KSIDC, has 6 facilities inclusive of industrial growth centers, mega food park. The state's Directorate of Industry and Commerce and Kerala Small Industries Development Corporation Limited has over 100 industrial development areas, zones for SMEs. Kerala has been ranked 5th in the Good Governance Index published by the Government of India. It has made huge improvements in several areas, including the ease of doing business, and industrial growth is now ranked 1st among southern states. Kerala has been the front runner in India on the social development front. It is a leader in achievement of sustainable development goals relating to health, education, and gender equality. Kerala has maintained its position as the best performing large state in terms of overall performance, according to the latest Niti Aayog Health Index 2019-20, for several years in a row. These are reflections of the policies that the state has adopted in health-related sectors, in governance in general. The government of Kerala has taken many path-breaking initiatives to support and drive investments in key segments of healthcare industry. I am just mentioning a few important ones, just to illustrate the vitality of the approach that the state is adopting when it comes to attracting industrial investments. The first is the Bio360 Life Sciences Park, established at Thonakkal in Thiruvananthapuram. The objective is to create a holistic ecosystem for life science, spanning across research to commercial manufacturing across different segments. The park would primarily focus on the areas of medical devices and technologies, biotechnology and biopharmaceuticals, nutraceuticals and animal health. It will be an ideal facility for research, development and manufacturing of vaccines. A medical devices park, Meds Park, is being planned in the first phase of Life Sciences Park as a joint initiative of the KSIDC and Sri Chitra Thirunal Institute for Medical Sciences and Technology. Government of Kerala has taken a very timely step as part of its medium and long-term strategy to meet the challenges posed by the pandemic. This is the decision to set up a vaccine production center in the capital city of Thiruvananthapuram as part of the Bio360 Life Sciences Park. The state government has announced a package of incentives for bidders. Bids have been invited to set up the park and are in an advanced stage of selection. The presence of the new Institute of Advanced Virology and several institutions of eminence in biological sciences at Thiruvananthapuram is at Indian Institute of Sciences Education and Research, IISER, Rajiv Gandhi Center for Biotechnology, RGCB, Sri Chitra Thirunal Institute for Medical Sciences and Technology, SCTIMST, National Institute for Interdisciplinary Sciences, CSIR, NIIST, Kerala University Campus with variety of courses and research facilities in biological sciences provide the kind of environment and ecosystem in Kerala where pharma companies and companies in the health-related sector and related R&D can thrive and prosper. The second notable development in this direction is the setting up of the Petrochemical Park Kochi by the Kerala Industrial Infrastructure Development Corporation, KINFRA, for petrochemical downstream products. What is important for the healthcare industry is that a dedicated zone is earmarked in this park for investments by pharmaceutical industries. The park offers facilities like single window clearance, eco-friendly infrastructure, shared common infrastructure facilities, land in parcels, and built-up space for establishment of units. A third key development is the announcement of Kerala Medical Technology Consortium under the Kerala Development and Innovation Strategy Councils, KDISC. This initiative aims at positioning Kerala as a medical technology and devices hub. KMTC is a futuristic and highly ambitious program. The vision is to create an appropriate ecosystem in the state to foster medical innovation. R&D, technology development, and manufacturing over the next decade. The overall objective of the proposed consortium is to make Kerala a hub for advanced medical devices and technology development and a thriving manufacturing destination. In this phase of the state's industrial development, Kerala is looking for setting up industries in the knowledge economy sector. As part of this initiative, the state government has launched the Kerala Knowledge Economy Mission, an umbrella program that aims at providing 2 million jobs in the knowledge economy in the next 5 years. Kerala is an exciting and dynamic phase in its economic development. Our aspiration is to become the leader in attracting investors to the state in industries that conform to the overarching goals of environmental sustainability. We will achieve this goal with determination and focus. The state is looking for strategic partnerships. We can assure you that the state's facilities are comparable to the best in the country. The state is gifted with strengths that are better than what is found in other regions in the country. On natural resources, we are blessed with an abundance of water, a clean and hygienic environment. We can offer you the most literate workforce in the country, which is even comparable with several regions in developing nations. On behalf of the state government, I welcome all of you to share in the development aspirations of the state and become a partner for our genuine and sincere quest to achieve inclusive socio-economic development. Thank you.